Hello, 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 hello. Hi, it's Adanna here. Welcome back to my channel. Oh my god, y'all. I know I haven't been here in such a long time. I'm so sorry. It's been a lot going on, but don't worry, I have an update video coming up very soon. Today is going to be all about this hair. I was so excited to show you all this hair because it looks so natural. The curl pattern of this hair made me type 3C/4A natural hair. It's so convenient. It's one of your grab and go wigs. You don't really have to do anything at all. No lace front, no got to be. And the fact that it's a kinky headband wig just puts the icing on top of the cake, like So this hair is from my first wig. When they say my first wig, they were not lying at all, because this wig is very perfect for beginners. If this is the first wig that you're ever owning in your entire life, it comes with everything inside that you need to hold your wig down. It comes with a comb, it comes with edge brush, it comes with butterfly clamps, it comes with a wig cap, it comes with bobby pins. In fact, it even comes with a wig stand and some extra headbands that you use to change up your style, switch it up here and there. Everything and everything you need to install your wig. The specs of this hair is in 18 inches. As I previously mentioned, this is a 3C/4A curl pattern. As always, I'm going to have the details of this entire hair down below in the description box for your convenience. So the first thing I'm going to go ahead right now to do is to co-wash this hair. I use the Kaleidoscope Moisture Silk Conditioner. Apply some of this on my palms and just went ahead to rub this through the extension. So the point of me actually co-washing this hair is to rejuvenate the curls, and also of course to show you guys how to wash your headband wigs. Rejuvenate the curls, make sure everything is popping fresh and nice. Also, co-washing this hair is also going to cleanse the hair a little bit. I didn't want to have to use a hair shampoo to wash this hair, just because it's going to strip the hair of moisture. Then I'll have to go ahead to deep condition. So I just wanted to do like a quick co-wash to cleanse the hair a little bit while rejuvenating the entire curls. You can see once I applied the conditioner, it was just so easy to brush through this entire hair to make sure that all the curls are popping, it's rejuvenated, and it's properly detangled. And once I was done washing this hair, I went ahead to use my blow dryer, as you guys can see me do right now, to dry this entire unit. However, if you don't even want to use a blow dryer, or you don't have a blow dryer at all, you could just air dry this the night before, just so the following day your hair is going to be dry and it's all ready for you. But you all, I was such in a hurry on this day, that's why I had to use a blow dryer. Moving on to my natural hair, I'm just going to go ahead to use a wig cap to hold down my natural hair in place. Like I said in my previous headband wig video, the color of the wig cap used doesn't matter at all, because everything is going to end up being covered anyways. So it doesn't matter if your wig cap is brown, black, any color would work perfectly fine. And right now I'm just going to go ahead to fix up my edges, you know, just some cute swoop swoop, using the Style Factor Edge Booster Pomade. As you all know, that Edge Booster Pomade actually turns my edges white, so I normally go over top of that to use the Style Factor Edge Booster Gel, something more water-based to combat the entire whitish residue that I normally get from the pomade. And then right now, I'm just going ahead to move my wig cap a little bit to the front and then just slightly push it backwards to make sure that all of my hair is probably tucked in and my edges are looking, you know, looking very slayed and laid and nice and cute, all that good stuff. And then I went ahead to use my satin head wrap to tie over my entire edges just to hold it down while I went ahead to do my makeup. So this is basically 1 hour later. My edges are all dry, everything is in place, my makeup is also dashing it out. And then right now I'm just going to go ahead to apply this wig. It's so soft, I love the texture of this unit. And with the entire co-washing that I did, it just made it even softer and just very juicy. It just made it very mush mush. It was just so perfect. The construction of this wig comes with 3 combs inside of it, and it also has this little strap that I went ahead to adjust mine just so it's a lot tighter and it stays on my head perfectly in place. To put on this unit, I just went ahead to throw this on, and then I used the clips, the 2 clips on the side of this hair, like the 2 is it hook clips? Yeah, those 2 things that looks like comb. Yeah, that's what I used. I used those to hold it down by attaching it to my wig cap, like you all will see me do just right now. So I just pulled it a little bit in front, hooked it right there, boom, and it just stays in place. It doesn't move at all. Because I know a lot of people are worried about their headband wig sliding off their head. So this gives you that extra security so that your wig doesn't slide off when you're trying to look cute. And I went ahead to mesh together this Velcro at the back to hold everything together. You know what's funny? I actually didn't know this was called Velcro until you all told me in my last video. So now moving back to styling this hair, I'm going to go ahead to spritz some water just because the water that I had on this hair from the entire washing process has already dried down completely. You might wonder, like, why did I actually dry the hair down if I'm going to end up spritzing water on it again? So the main reason why I actually dried the hair prior to installing it was because I wanted the headband in front to be dry. That is a clothing material and I don't think you want to be wearing a wet headband on your head because it makes the headband to be more prone to sliding off. And also the inside of the entire headband wig construction has some form of clothing material, and just having the inside of your wig wet is just no. I don't think that's a good idea. Now to set this entire curls, I went ahead to use my Cream of Nature Styling Mousse. And I'm just applying this generously onto these curls just so everything is popping, it's fresh, it's looking luscious, it's looking scrumptious, and it's just giving it right here. This was basically all I did for the curls of this unit, y'all. As always, I'm going to go ahead right now to show you all different ways you can style your headband wig. The very first headband wig that I tried was also from my first wig, the one I showed you guys. That one had a looser curl pattern. So right now I'm just going to show you guys different ways you could style your kinky headband wig. First style is basically having this headband wig all the way to the back and also having these curls at the sides that are just popping, flowing, and just all looking fresh. I love the convenience of this headband wigs, y'all. Can you see how natural this looks though? Like, can you see? And then for this next hairstyle, I'm going to be using this little fancy bobby pin. I just use that to clip the two sides of this wig to give you that little bit of a puffy all back, poof poof, slick in front, poof at the back kind of look. I thought this hairstyle was very cute, very different, and with the entire fancy bobby pin, it just added that little bit of sparkle to the entire look. You could also use an elastic rope to kind of like hold it into a low puff kind of thing, and to give a very similar look to this as well. And then the very last hairstyle, which is my favorite hairstyle all the time, is to use this this head wrap. I feel like I've used this head wrap in almost every single video. Just love it so much, and the way the color just pops, it just adds a whole different vibe. Party look, church look, work look, in fact every look, this look is always a look. So right, I'm just going to go ahead to tie this head wrap towards the front. And once I make that one big knot, just go ahead to grab the hair, fold it a little bit and tuck it in right there in the middle. And then grab one side of this head wrap and then wrap it around, grab the other side and clap it right there at the side. Tie it into two knots and then tuck in the rest of this extra head wrap on the sides and everywhere else. Once I'm done tucking in this entire head wrap, I'll just go ahead right now to neatly grab this hair in the middle and wrap it properly and tuck it in properly into this head wrap just so everything is nice and secure. And then right now all I have left is this little side fro bangs going on right here in front. This is such a look. Like, this is my favorite hairstyle, y'all. This hairstyle remains serving scrumptious delicacies all the time. The two previous hairstyles, if you all want to switch things a little bit, you could also go ahead to include like a colorful headband, like the ones that came with this entire wig package. And that's basically it for this video. Let me know down below in the comment section which of these three hairstyles was your favorite one. As previously mentioned, the entire details of this hair is going to be down below in the description box, and I will see you all in my next one. Have a wonderful rest of the week. Love you all so much. Bye. One time. She's got to be. Lego. Lego. Passing the prime. Them girls, them I come, them I feel alive. One by one. Them I step in on me yard, them I enter, them be. By two, oh, who yeah, me? Yeah. Go low. Man, I tell him, me then go slow. Them a feeling, no my vibe, and see these girls, them go down.